Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Michael Penn of the Shingetsu News Agency, and I'll be your moderator for today. So normally I would kind of give my free introduction to our folks here, but I've been given a script this time to kind of explain specifically what this is about. So let me read this briefly. Regarding the Futenma Marine Base issue, the New Diplomacy Initiative, ND, launched the Henoko Alternative Project and has been holding workshops with security and defense experts. The statement of Japanese Prime Minister Abe and President Trump at the February summit said, quote, Henoko is the only solution to the Futenma issue, unquote. But the workshop members doubt that this is true. Having seen the Henoko construction delayed for 20 years due to strong opposition in Okinawa, Henoko does not even seem very realistic. Usually the discussion over the issue is just a simple one, such as US bases in Okinawa are necessary because they deter China. There is very little discussion over the Okinawa base issues from the professional security perspective. This report discusses US presence in Okinawa in detailed, from a detailed security perspective, and proposes one possible alternative solution. The New Diplomacy Initiative is a Tokyo-based think tank with the purpose of bringing diverse voices to diplomacy, especially US-Japan diplomacy. Kyoji Yanagisawa is a former Assistant Chief Cabinet Secretary and a board member of the New Diplomacy Initiative. Tomohiro Yara is a former editorial board member of the Okinawa Times and is also a board member of the New Diplomacy Initiative, as well as a lecturer at the Okinawa International University. Shigeru Handa is a member of the editorial board of the Tokyo Shimbun. And Akihiro Sado is a professor at Chukyo University. The whole report in Japanese is published today, and there is some English summary attached as well. So the way we're going to do this is that one of these gentlemen is going to speak for about 20 minutes in English, and then there'll be a very brief comment in Japanese by the other three, and then we'll open it up to the floor for your questions and answers, at which time please direct your question to one of the four members to save time. So thank you very much. If you have an iPhone or mobile phone that makes noise, now would be a good time to make sure it doesn't disrupt us in the middle of the festivities. All right, please, you may begin.
Good afternoon. I'm Yara, Tomohiro Yara. I just arrived from Okinawa an hour ago. Quite cold here. I feel very lucky and happy to be Okinawan. So please let me start our my presentation about our recommendations, alternative to Henoko. Well, thank you very much again for coming today to listen to our recommendation on an alternative to Henoko. In 1996, that's about 20 years ago, Japan and the United States agreed to return U.S. Marine Corps Air Station Futenma and build replacement facility off the Henoko, off the shore of the Henoko, Nago City. After more than 20 years passed, the Futenma replacement facility, FRF, is not yet built because of the locals' opposition. It must be the time now to think about an alternative to the Henoko plan. Our new diplomacy initiative would like to recommend a new solution to the Futenma issue. The recommendations are, we propose to make minor change in the U.S. force realignment agreement between U.S. and Japanese government in 2012 and move the 31st MEU, that stands for Marine Expeditionary Unit, out of Okinawa. And as a result of that, the Futenma replacement facility would not be needed because it is the 31st MEU uses Futenma. When the unit should go out of Okinawa, Futenma will be returned to local without any replacement. We introduce a new concept of cooperation between U.S. Marine Corps and Japanese Self-Defense Force. We call it JPUS Joint MEU Marine Expeditionary Unit, that stands for humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. We recommend that the Japanese government provide a high-speed vessel to 31st MU as a connector to different locations in the Asia-Pacific. And Japan would consider to continue host nation support at a place where the 31st MU would to be relocated from Okinawa. Okinawa can provide a venue for international coordination for humanitarian assistance and disaster relief in the Asia-Pacific. Okinawa will act as a center for soft power, not a fortress left over from the Cold War. Now, Okinawa is a base for all four forces, the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Marine Corps. The biggest forces in Okinawa is Marine, which alone occupies 75% of the base in Okinawa and accounts for 60% of all the forces stationed in the island. As you can see in that slide, all this area shaded in orange are all the Marines. So it makes very big difference in on Okinawa issue if there's a Marines in Okinawa or not. So our study focused on the Marines. where are we? Many problems have resulted from this situation of the disproportionate U.S. Marine presence, military presence, especially the U.S. Marines in Okinawa. Traffic accident, crime, noise, and many other social problems are the result. The Japan and U.S. government decided to reduce footprint on Okinawa under the Defense Posture Review, known as the U.S. Military Alignment. Under the agreement, the Marine Corps in Marine troops in Okinawa would be reduced to half, about to 10,000 from 18,000. The most surprising move is the relocation of 4th Marine Regiment to Guam. That is the only Marine regiment in Okinawa. What would remain in Okinawa would be the only the commanding element of the 3rd Marine Expeditionary Force, the 3rd MEF, and the smallest air ground task force, the 31st MU. With the realignment, the Marines ground combat element would be scaled down to 1/4 of the current level. A MU is made up of 2,000 Marines composed of only 800 to 1,000 land combat troops and 500 aviation unit troops and 300 logistic troops. That small task force is mainly designed for peacetime operations such as humanitarian assistance and disaster relief and non-combatant evacuation operations. 31st MU is traveling the Pacific for more than 6 months per year on amphibious ships assigned to Sasebo Naval Port in Nagasaki Prefecture. They visit allied countries and conduct joint training. They keep close tie with Asian nations through military diplomacy. Recently, the MU is actively engaged in international training forces training focused on humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. This slide gives you an idea of how the U.S. Marine Corps uses Okinawa as a rendezvous point to marry ship from Sasebo in Nagasaki with a MUSE component element deployed from the continental United States. Thus, this rendezvous point does not necessarily need to be in Okinawa, but could be anywhere in mainland Japan if they are welcomed. However, we think it is almost impossible to find an alternative location within Japan. Our recommendation is to move the 31st MU to Guam or Australia or even to Hawaii. It could also stay in California because all the component elements are sent to Okinawa for 6 month deployed rotation from the US mainland. They can make a Pacific tour from anywhere they can get aboard. With that simple alternative, the Futenma issue can be solved after 20 years. Many bases will be returned to locals, and the US military base issue in Okinawa will be greatly alleviated. We propose Japan-US joint MU for HADR, H-A-D-L. Well, the military people, they call it HADR. That stands HA and DL, that stands for humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. The picture on the slide is activities of the 31st MU from Okinawa participating in Balikatan 2012, international joint training in the Philippines. The Marines are carrying not rifles, as you can see, it is the shovels. They are repairing the floor of a schoolroom in a rural area of the Philippines. The clay ground become muddy after every rain. The Marines were making a concrete floor as part of a humanitarian assistance project. They also provide medical care to local residents. According to the Marine strategic doctrine, this kind of humanitarian assistance would draw local people's mind away from terrorist propaganda. They call these soft power activities a kind of war on terror or war on ideology. The MU, Marine Expeditionary Unit, also leads international training designed to cope up with natural disaster. During Balikatan 2012, 11 nations military forces participated disaster relief desktop exercise. There were Japanese self-defense force, Australian, Vietnamese, and Indonesian troops, and in addition, the Chinese sent commanding element for the exercise. It was the first time that China participated in an international exercise in Asia Pacific. The following year, the Chinese People's Liberation Army sent land troops to Cobra Gold 2014 in Thailand. Zi Guangzhu, I'm not sure I properly pronounce his name, but it seems so. Zi Guangzhu, Lieutenant General of PLA, said Chinese participation in a Chinese participation is a declaration of commitment to a better security environment in the Asia Pacific in cooperation with the United States. He was quoted in the South China Post, Morning Post, as I think it's based on Hong Kong. This type of international training has become more popular now, and many nations are participating and anticipated to join. Through this joint training, focused on humanitarian assistance and disaster relief, Asian nations can seek a better security environment. Today, security issues are symbolized with two tragic events, 9/11, the terrorist attack at New York, and March 11, devastating earthquake in northern part of Japan. According to the World Bank, natural disaster affected 16 million people and caused $4.5 billion of damage in the Asia Pacific from 1980 to 2011. According to the UN, the chances of natural disaster occurring in Asia Pacific is 3.2 times greater than in Africa, 5.5 times greater than in Central America, 9 times greater than in North America, and 67 times greater than in Europe. So I'd like to welcome all of you to this dangerous world from the world over. Now, the only four nations can sufficiently conduct disaster relief operation in Pacific, namely United States, China, Japan, and Australia. So we need the cooperation among the Asian nations. We believe that the conceptions of a Japan-US joint MEU can meet the most urgent need of Asia-Pacific security. To support activities of the joint MEU, we propose that the Japanese government provide a high-speed vessel to the 31st MEU. The annual lease cost of that kind of vessel in Japan is $9 million. To build a new one, it costs about $45 million. And also, we like to propose the Japanese government to provide financial assistance to the 31st MEU for facility development at the place where the 31st MEU will relocate its base from Okinawa. The total host nation's support by Japan now was $3.3 billion in fiscal year 2016. Of that, $193 million was allocated to facility improvement program, equivalent to the military construction budget or MILCON. Marine base in Okinawa were given about $26 million. So 31st MEU will get $9 million for high-speed vessel and $26 million for MILCON, makes $35 million every year. Well, if we make a Futenma replacement facility, it costs $3 billion only to landfill, and total cost is estimated close to $10 billion. We recommend a revision of the U.S. military force realignment that moves the 31st MEU out of Okinawa. We propose establishment of Japan-U.S. joint MEU for harbor. We also propose that the Japanese government support the 31st MEU to move to new location by providing high-speed vessel and facility improvement funds. These recommendations will save billions of dollars and save the beautiful coral sea at Henoko, which is inhabited by the dugong, endangered species dugong. Our recommendation of a joint MEU for harbor aim to create a platform for security cooperation among Asia-Pacific countries, including China. Japan will be able to join security maintenance activities in a peace manner. Our recommendation not only to solve the U.S. military base issue in Okinawa, but also may provide a new vision for 21st century security network. We hope our recommendation will provide a new and creative approach to long and twisted problem of Okinawa. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Yara, for the opening presentation. Now we'll have just very brief comments in Japanese with translation from the other three members. Our interpreter's name is Sandy Aritsa, so please do a good job here as we get these short comments. Thank you very much.
今までこの問題が解決しなかったのは、ちょっと考え方を変えればいくらでもその解決の道は見えるだろうということなんですね。そのことを我々は提言したかったんですね。The reason that this problem has not been solved yet is because nobody has been able to come up with a reasonable solution, but we worked our hardest to come up with such a solution.
で、それでもなおかつ安全保障のスペシャリストからは海兵隊が沖縄からいなくなれば 中国に間違ったメッセージを送ることになるという心配があります。
Up until now, there has always been the concern, among security specialists that if the Marines were to leave Okinawa, it would send the wrong message to China.
しかし、その中国とアメリカの、争いというか競争は海上と空のスプレマシーをめぐるものであって、2000人の31ミューが沖縄にいることというのは軍事的にはほとんど意味がないと私は思います。
But the competition between China and the United States, really takes place in the seas and the sky, the fighting for supremacy of the seas and the sky. And so the 2,000 troop 31st Mew in Okinawa really militarily has no significance.
日本の陸上自衛隊は、31ミューは、2000人と申し上げましたけども、3000人の、アンフィビアスのブリゲードを作る計画を持っています。
We've mentioned that the 31st Mew is made up of 2,000 personnel, but the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Force actually plans to construct a 3,000 troop amphibious brigade.
ですから、中国に対して誤ったメッセージを送るということが問題なのではなくて、沖縄に海兵隊がいることによって、日本が、中国と尖閣をめぐる戦争になった場合、アメリカが海兵隊を使って守ってくれるという間違った日本に対する間違ったメッセージをね、送ることになるのではないかということを、アメリカ政府に、サジェストをしたいなと私は思います。以上です。
So, what I would like to suggest to the United States government is that rather than, the Marines leaving Okinawa sending the wrong message to China, I believe that actually, the idea that the Marines in Okinawa, will inevitably protect Japan, were there to be a war with China or over the Senkaku Islands, Japanese people may think that the Marines, the U.S. will use the Marines to protect Okinawa or the Senkakus, in the, such a case. And so I think that's actually sending a wrong message to the Japanese people.
Okay.
Okay. 私は東京新聞で25年間にわたって防衛省自衛隊そして、在日米軍の、まあ、取材をしてきました。
For 25 years at the Tokyo Shimbun, I covered the Japanese Defense Agency, the Self-Defense Forces, and the U.S. forces in Japan.
で、日米の、まあ、やり取りがさまざま行われる中で、もうすでに2012年には2プラス2があり、そこで沖縄の海兵隊の実戦部隊が31ミューだけになるということが決まりました。
There have been many negotiations between the United States and Japan, but in 2012 there was a 2+2 meeting, where it was decided that the only Marines to remain in Okinawa would be the 31st Mew.
で、沖縄の海兵隊が、まあ、抑止力であるという説明がよくなされます。
We often hear that the Marines in Okinawa are a deterrent force.
で、その抑止力が、まあ、小さくなる一方で、で日本の防衛省は先ほど柳沢さんが言ったような、まあ、水陸機動団という日本版の海兵隊を1年後には設立をします。
So as this deterrent force in Okinawa gets smaller, on the other hand, the Japanese Defense Ministry has decided, as Mr. Yanagisawa just said, to make in the Self-Defense Forces a new amphibious brigade within 1 year.
で、この部隊は、まあ、機動性を持っています。まあ、それは例えば揚陸艦といった艦艇や輸送機で、そしてヘリコプターなどで、まさに海兵隊の肩代わりができる能力を持っています。
This new brigade will be, have great readiness and be rapidly deployable. It will have many of the same equipment that the Marines have. It will almost be able to fulfill the function of the Marines. It will have amphibious ships, carrier aircraft, as well as helicopters.
で、尖閣諸島を含む日本の領土を守るのは、 日本政府の責任です。
It is the responsibility of the Japanese government to protect Japanese territory, including the Senkaku Islands.
そのために、防衛力を強めつつある現在、沖縄で、削減される海兵隊の穴埋めを自衛隊自らが行う、そういうことが可能になろうとしています。
In order to do that, as Japan continues to increase its defense capabilities, as the Marines in Okinawa are reduced, Japan is working to be able to fill that gap that will be created with its own capabilities.
まあ、したがって、最後の実戦部隊になる31ミューが沖縄から海外に移転していくとしても、そこは自衛隊、そしてまた日米安全保障条約による米軍の来援によって安全と平和は維持されるというふうに確信をしています。以上です。
So I believe that even if the 31st MU, which is now planned to remain in Okinawa, were to instead be stationed abroad, I think it would still be possible to protect peace and safety using the self-defense forces as well as the U.S.-Japan Security Alliance and U.S. military support when needed.
I am 日本の防衛政策の歴史を中心に研究してきました。
My name is Sado, and I focus mainly on Japanese defense policy.
言うまでもなく沖縄は米軍基地が集中しておりまして、で、日本の日米の安保条約というのは、日本をアメリカに守ってもらう代わりに、アメリカの戦略のために日本の中に基地を置いて使ってくださいという交換条約です。
As you all know, the U.S. bases are concentrated in Okinawa, and the U.S.-Japan security treaty is based on the premise that the United States will protect Japan, and in exchange, Japan will provide the United States with military bases.
95年9月の不幸な少女暴行事件以来、沖縄の中での基地反対運動は高まっているわけですけれども、基地が集中している沖縄で、基地に対する反対運動が非常に高まるということは、日米安保条約自体に対するその非常に大きな脅威でもあるということにもなります。
After the terrible rape incident in September of 1995, anti-US base activity in Okinawa increased greatly, and anti-base activity is, we should really say, a threat to the, maybe the biggest threat to the U.S.-Japan Security Treaty.
この20年以上沖縄に毎年何度も通って沖縄の世論を見てきましたけれども、明らかに変化をしてきています。
Over the past 20 years, I've gone to Okinawa frequently, and I always ask people and follow theOkinawan public opinion, and I feel that over the past years, it has actually changed quite greatly.
それは90年代はまだ、その基地負担の不公平ということを強く主張する声はあっても、それほど多くの人が差別という言葉を口にしておりませんでした。
In the 1990s, there were many people who would say that the concentration of bases in Okinawa is unfair, but there was no one who would say that Okinawa was facing discrimination.
最近は多くの沖縄の人たちは自分たちは差別されていると主張しています。
However, recently, many Okinawan people have come to say that they are facing discrimination.
で、大変不幸なことに沖縄の基地をめぐる報道についても、今日は海兵隊のことを議論していますが、普天間基地を沖縄から移す、海外に移すなどということを議論すると、沖縄から米軍がいなくなってもいいのかというような単純な議論になってしまいます。
Unfortunately, every time we hear about the Okinawa base issue in the media, today we talked specifically about the Marines, but every time we hear about moving the Futenma base, perhaps out of Okinawa or abroad, we always have someone say, is it really okay for the US military to leave Okinawa entirely?
沖縄の人たちにとっては基地負担の不公平だけではなくて自分たちの考えていること自分たちの気持ちがきちんと本土に伝わっていないと いうことについての差別感というのがますます高くなっていると、強くなっているということです。
Among Okinawan people, there is a greater and greater sense that it is not just unfair, but rather that their own thoughts, their own opinions, their own feelings are not really being conveyed to people in the Japanese mainland, and people interpret that as discrimination.
大変残念なことに、本土で行われている沖縄基地問題に関する議論は、海兵隊イコール抑止力イコールなくてはならないものという非常に単純化された議論に終わってしまっています。
Very unfortunately, most of the debate going on about Okinawa base issues in the mainland basically centers around the argument that the Marines are deterrents and therefore they are necessary. It's very simplified.
私たちの今回の提案は、海兵隊の役割というのは何なのか、沖縄にある米軍全体の役割は何なのかということをもっときちんとですね、専門的に検討した結果、導き出されたものです。
Our suggestion today really focused on what is the role of the Marines in Okinawa, what is the role of the entire U.S. military presence in Okinawa. We wanted to really look that over from a perspective of specialists and look at what the real details of this is.
これまでにない提案ということで、ぜひ皆さんにも検討していただけるとありがたいと思っております。以上です。
I believe there has never been another recommendation like the one we're presenting today, and so I hope you will all take a very good look at it.
Okay, well now we're going to open it up to a question and answer period. I will begin with the working press. So if I call on you, please come to the microphone there, identify your name and your affiliation, and to try to keep your question rather straightforward and to the point. I'm opening it up now. Anybody would like to ask the first question? Okay, Christoph.
Süddeutsche Zeitung, Neidhardt. We have heard this week that the Japanese government actually pays for most of what comes out of Washington in terms of comments and recommendations about Okinawa. Obviously, even Richard Armitage said, if the Japanese think there's another solution, that's fine. Do you think it is the whole question is about the Marines, or does Prime Minister Abe just want to build Henoko for the future use of Japanese self-defense forces?
Would you like to translate that?
以前に日本政府がワシントンから来る多くの沖縄に関するコメントを日本政府は実はお金を出しているという話を聞いたんですけれども、リチャード・アーメテジさんも日本がもし別の解決策があるとお考えであれば私たちもそれを考えますと発言したことがあると思います。そのところで安倍首相は辺野古の基地は海兵隊のために作るのか、それともいつか将来に日本の自衛隊が使うために作りたがっているのか、どう思われますか。
どうしよう。皆さん、
出るでしょう。僕？Me？
ちょっといい。
For me？ Oh, okay。
答え、まあ答えられ、今作っているのは、まあ、あくまでも海兵隊のための移転先としての基地でありますけれども、2012年以前民主党政権の時に、日本側からアメリカに対して、キャンプシュワブの共同使用というものを、まあ、提案したことがありました。まあ、沖縄の基地は現在もキャンプハンセンで自衛隊と米軍が共同使用していますけれども、
The base being built right now is officially for the Marines. It is meant to be a replacement facility for the Marines to relocate from Futenma. However, in 2012, I believe during the Democratic Party era, Japan proposed that U.S. Marine Camp Schwab in Okinawa be used for U.S. and Japan joint training. Currently, actually, Camp Hansen, also in Okinawa, is being used for joint training between the United States military and the self-defense forces.
したがいまして、米軍基地は沖縄に限らず全て自衛隊が使う可能性はありますけれども、とりわけ沖縄の海兵隊が将来海外に移転していった跡地として、自衛隊が利用するということは十分日本政府も検討していると思います。
So it is already the case that the self-defense forces are participating in joint exercises and using U.S. bases, not only in Okinawa, but also in other parts of Japan. So I believe it is very possible that the Japanese government is considering right now that if the Marines were ever to leave Okinawa, the self-defense forces would use the base at Henoko.
ただし、もちろん不要になった基地は、自衛隊も使わないで、海兵隊も出ていくということになれば、当然、沖縄の人々に返還されるというふうに理解しています。
一言。
But I believe that, okay. I believe that if a, the base becomes unnecessary, I think that the Marines would leave and also the self-defense forces would not use it, but rather it would be returned to the Okinawan people.
私、ちょっと補足しますが、一番大事なことは、今の普天間の新しい基地というのは、自衛隊のオペレーションのためにデザインされてはいないということですね。あくまでもアメリカの海兵隊、そして大きな輸送機がそこに来ることを前提に設計されており、自衛隊のために、自衛隊が使うためにの設計にはなってないということです。
I would like to add one important comment. I think the most important thing to consider is that the new base, the Futenma replacement facility, is not designed for SDF use. It is being designed for use by the U.S. Marines specifically. It is being designed to accommodate transport aircraft, and it is not designed for the SDF.
Any other questions from the working press?
Thank you. Eric Slavin with Stars and Stripes. The Marines, any MEU is designed primarily as an initial assault unit in the event of a war. Humanitarian missions are more of a secondary mission. If you're moving them farther away and there is an outbreak of war in Taiwan, possibly North Korea, how are they able to still fulfill that mission, especially given that Guam has already rejected having a larger number of troops being sent?To their island because it's a small island, and California and Australia are both quite far away in the event of a war breaking out. Thank you.
じゃあ私が。
どうぞ、please interpret.
Ah, okay.
海兵隊のミューというのは、最も重要な義務は、もし有事があった場合に、すぐに駆けつけるということだと思いますが、そうなんですけど。でそのヒマニタリアンアシスタンスというのはセコンダリーな役割です。ですから台湾や北朝鮮などにもし有事があった場合には海兵隊がなければそのミューがなければどのようにその役割を果たすのか、グアムはすでに反対しているし、小さな島なので、それからカリフォルニアやオーストラリアはとても遠いなので、どういうふうに対応するのですか。
I think Marines are very much capable force, so they can manage, I think, any way. And also, as I have explained, what is going to happen after 2025 when the realignment will be really taking place, the other regiment.We'll be moving to Guam. And Marine, as you know, is the smallest task force. And their ships are in Sasebo. So it is like when you ride a train, the train starts from Sasebo and you ride in Okinawa. It can ride on, I mean, they can ride on Kumamoto, or it can ride on, they can ride on Kagoshima, anywhere they can, because they are. you know, such a rapid deployable force. So they cannot, they shouldn't be, I mean, they can do their job very well at anywhere, you know, other than Okinawa. So we're not saying, well, we're not picking one place. They can, well, Marine can pick a place, but Okinawa is oversaturated. So if we leave this problem, it's gonna grow up in someday, I guess. It's getting harder and harder. I mean, I'm talking about local people's struggle and oppositions. So the governor Onaga is quite now he's becoming a masterpiece. I mean, symbolic to represent Okinawa's feeling. He's calling for Okinawa's, you know, Okinawans how do you call it? Independent something? I mean, independent mind?
Self-determination.
I'm sorry, self-determination, independence is a very dangerous word, I'm sorry. self-determination. So we are feeling that as Sato-sensei explained it to you, our, you know, some sort of antagonistic feeling is getting blow up. So I think whether we're going to think about the Taiwan Strait contingency or to keep Okinawa's sustainability for U.S. military base, I think, which is important for now. And the choice is very, I think it's clear, to relocate 31st MU or to put all the other U.S. military bases, including Kadena, in danger of meeting people's protest. So, which is good for us, for everybody. I think it's not only a single issue for Marines or for Taiwan Strait. We're talking about the entire Asia-Pacific security issues. I think they are very much capable, Marines. They can come from anywhere. And that is shown in a realignment already. I mean, military realignment.
Okay, any more from the working press before we move on? All right, so Mr. Fujita, you can be next.
My name is Hiroki Fujita, former editor and writer for the Kokubi Shimbun. And currently I'm freelance basis for Yukan Fuji. And I'd like to ask a question to Mr. Handa. You said Self-Defense Forces is trying to replace the U.S. Marine. But I wonder if this is possible because of the, you know, legal boundaries, because Self-Defense Forces extension of the police reserve, that's not really legal, it's not a military force. So are you recommending that we should also change the legal boundaries, amend the Constitution, Article 9? Is that what you are trying to suggest?
自衛隊が新しいブリゲードを作る、それが海兵隊の役割を果たすとおっしゃったんですけど、今日本において法律的な問題があると思います。つまり憲法9条という問題ですけど、憲法9条を改正した方がいいとおっしゃってますか？いえ、憲法9条が今のままであったとしても、新しく作られる水陸機動団という海兵隊のような組織は、 日本が他国から侵略をされた時に、日本防衛のために戦うということに今限定されているので、憲法上の問題は生じないということです。
That was not what I was suggesting, actually. Even if Article 9 stays as it is currently, the new amphibious brigade being created by the SDF will be used to defend Japan, to fight to defend Japan in the case that Japan were to be attacked by another country, invaded by another country, and its use would be limited to that.
Okay, open to questions. Yes, Siegfried.
Secret little freelancer from Germany. It's not that not the bases in Okinawa. The main reason for this bases now, there's a symbol of of the commitment of the Japan to the United States to be an ally, and on the other side also from the U.S. To Japan to be an ally. So if there would be any change, does it not mean that the whole trust from Japan in U.S. or on the other side from U.S. in Japan will be in danger? There could be they no longer then and after they're no longer kind of allies or thing in this way. Does it not mean to abolish the bases in Okinawa? Does it not mean this kind of trust will be lost? Because I think military, there's no military necessary for the bases now, because there are no very dangerous bases very close to the Chinese missiles from 300 miles away. So, but the symbol is very.
ドイツのフリーランスです。沖縄には基地が非常に多いということですけど、その主な理由というのは、まあ、象徴的な理由ではないでしょうか。つまり日本がアメリカに対して同盟国であることを示して、アメリカが日本に対して同盟国であるということを示していると思います。もしそれが変わってしまえば、その2つの国の信頼関係が危ういのではないでしょうか。もう同盟自体がなくなるんじゃないですか。ですから沖縄から基地をなくすというのは、日本とアメリカの間の信頼関係が失われるのではないでしょうか。もちろん、軍事的には必要ではないかもしれませんが、まあ、しかも非常に人口密集地の中で非常に危険な基地でもありますが、もし閉鎖してしまえば、問題があるのではないですか。まあ、また中国のミサイルの距離以内でもありますが、だから軍事的な理由ではなくて象徴的な理由で必要なのではないでしょうか。
佐藤先生いきます。
私ですか、
はい。
先ほども議論しましたけれども、例えば沖縄にある最も重要な基地というのは嘉手納だと思います。空軍の基地ですけれども、これは本土、まあ、本州にある米軍基地を、まあ、ほとんど集めてもカバーできないぐらいの広さがある。で、柳沢さんも先ほどおっしゃいましたけれども、アメリカが例えばまあ、中国の問題であるとかに対して考えなければならないのは、今はやっぱり空軍と海軍のプレゼンスということだと思います。で、
As I mentioned before, I think the most important base in Okinawa is the Kadena Air Base, which belongs to the U.S. Air Force. The size of Kadena is so great that it is almost as big as all of the U.S. bases in the mainland Japan combined. And as Mr. Yanagisawa-san mentioned before, I think when it comes to the U.S. and China, I think the naval and air force presence are the most important.
沖縄の状況を先ほど申し上げましたけれども、この現在の基地負担の不公平、これは主に海兵隊によるものなんですけれども、これが続くと、それこそカデナに対する反対運動、カデナも返還しろというようなことになりかねない、そういうような不満が今沖縄県民の中に高まりつつあります。
If we look at the situation in Okinawa right now, we see that it is quite an unfair situation, and most of this is because of the Marines, and so there is a risk that if anti-base sentiment continues to grow in Okinawa, it might grow to extend past the Marines and include opposition to Kadena Air Base. People might start calling for the closure of Kadena Air Base as well, and that might be the result of the increase in dissatisfaction among Okinawans.
今のような不公平な状況をこのまま続けていくと、それこそカデナに対する返還運動につながり、日米安保体制、先ほどシンボルとおっしゃいましたが、日米安保体制自体を揺るがしかねないような事態になる恐れすらあるのではないかというふうに我々は考えています。
So what we believe is that if this unfair situation were to continue, the protest movement might come to include a call to close even the Air Force Base Kadena. And we believe that that would actually be a much more serious threat to the U.S.-Japan security arrangement.
ですから、先ほどから出ているように、自衛隊は何ができるのか、どこまでできるのか、そして海兵隊は何をしているのかというようなことをきちんと議論した上で、今回の我々の提案につながったというふうにお考えいただきたいというふうに思います。
So in coming up with our present recommendation, we looked at what the SDF is actually capable of doing and what the Marines are currently doing now, and we investigated that thoroughly in coming into our conclusion.
Okay, well, I would like to ask a question to take my moderator's privilege if I can. In the early 2010, then Prime Minister Hatoyama suggested that Tokunoshima might be a possible non-Okinawa solution to the realignment of the Marines. And this proposal was very quickly defeated by leaking to the newspapers, apparently from bureaucrats, that it was militarily infeasible, which was since found to be basically a lie to try to influence public opinion. And then, I believe it was in 2012 or so, then Defense Minister Morimoto said that the Henoko is the only solution, always really has to do with politics. It's not about military at all. So it's been sort of acknowledged, even by the defense minister of Japan, that this is a political issue, not really a military issue. So my question to you is, how do you move the politics when both sides, both at the political and bureaucratic level, seem to be absolutely determined not to move?
2010年に鳩山首相は、沖縄じゃない、普天間の移設先として徳之島を提案したと思いますが、これが日本の政府の官僚によってメディアに流してしまって、それからこれは軍事的には不可能という官僚からの情報がメディアに流れてしまって、これは本当は嘘だったんですけれども、日本の世論を操作するために言われたことです。それから2012年に森本防衛大臣が、辺野古が唯一というのは軍事的な理由ではなくて政治的な理由だとおっしゃったと思います。つまり日本の防衛省でさえもこれが軍事的な問題ではなくて政治的な問題であると言っています。その中ではこういう政治的な問題にどう対応するのか、つまり政治家も官僚も絶対に動きたくないと言っている中でどう対応するのですか。
それはもうファーマービューロクラット
。He says you have to reply because you are a former なんだビューロクラット。私はね、無理だと思ってます。実は彼らの日本の安全保障コミュニティの、マインドセットを変えるということはね、ほとんど不可能に近いと思っています。ただその代わり、そういうことをしていると我々が言っているように、やがて沖縄全体の米軍基地が非常にアンステーブルなものにならざるを得ないよという、我々は今警告をね、ウォーニングを出しているつもりであります。でこれをじゃあお願いします。
Actually, I think it's impossible. I think there's no way to change the mindset of the security community. But what we're trying to do is we're trying to sound a warning that if the situation is allowed to continue as it is, the opposition in Okinawa will grow to the extent that operation of U.S. bases there becomes very unstable.
そして世界に対しても、この問題のいかにこの問題が論理的に整合性が取れていないかということを訴えていきたいし、それから沖縄の人たちの反対は理由があることなんだということをね、主張することによって沖縄の人たちを励ましていきたいという
まあ、私は今できる私たちがこの提言で今、到達できる目標は その辺のところかと私は思っています。
So another thing we're trying to do is to send a message to the world that the current solution, so-called solution, really doesn't make any sense. And so we're also trying to convey that the people of Okinawa who are opposed to the current plan have reasons to be opposed. And by doing so, we're hoping to provide support to those people. I think that is the main goal of our current recommendation.
Okay, well, then we have we're going to wrap up here with a couple of bits of good news. First of all, although we have apparently still failed to move the opinions of the security community, these four gentlemen have just earned a one-year honorary membership in the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. So please let me give them their memberships and thank them for kindly for coming here today. They will stay a few more minutes if you would like. If you're a working journalist and you would like to get their meishi for to follow up or to get quotes in the future, they'll be here to give you their information. So please, that's the end of our event. Thank you for coming, and please come to our events as much as you can. Thank you very much.